We've closed a $535 million loan guarantee for Solyndra.
In 2009, the Obama administration gave Solyndra a $535 million taxpayer-funded loan guarantee.
More than half $1 billion.
The White House monitored the loan closely and pressured officials to hastily finish a financial review. Solyndra was the poster child of green stimulus projects.
A loan to Solyndra.
Companies like Solyndra.
Employees at Solyndra.
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 But why Solyndra? A key Solyndra investor was also a major Obama campaign donor.
The true engine of economic growth will always be companies like Solyndra.
Solyndra officials visited the White House at least 20 times.
It's so important we invest in Solyndra and invest in what Solyndra is doing.
And Solyndra benefited from a lower interest rate than other companies received.
It's happening right now. The future is here.
Solyndra is now bankrupt and under investigation by the FBI.
You're demonstrating that the promise of clean energy isn't just an article of faith, not anymore.
1,100 workers have been laid off.
These are the jobs of the future. These are the green jobs. These are the jobs that won't be exported.
And taxpayers could lose nearly half $1 billion. Solyndra, so bankrupt, so many questions for the White House.
Well, we've heard the president say again and again how green jobs are the key to the future. He gave one of those speeches at Solyndra, this company, Solyndra, the solar panel company in Fremont, California. So the federal government loaned Solyndra half $1 billion. Right? Because it was all in. This is going to be a great green jobs company. Let's help them. And 2 days ago, that company declared bankruptcy, putting 1,100 workers on the street. Now some Republican lawmakers want answers. One of them is Republican Congressman Cliff Stearns of Florida. He was on the House Energy and Commerce Committee. The chairman is, if I understand correctly, sir. Thank you so much for being here with us.
Sure.
All right. Let's just start. Our viewers, most of them, I guarantee you don't know anything about this. But when the feds wanted to make this $500 million loan to this green jobs company that the president wanted made, some Republicans like you said, wait a minute, the company doesn't look good. Let's hold on. Why are we doing this? And what were you told?
Well, basically, we had a hearing on this, and we found out that there was not proper oversight when they gave out half $1 billion to guarantee the making of solar panels in California by Solyndra. And it turns out that some of the people that were involved in getting this money were people that bundled large sums of money for the administration during their campaign. That got us very concerned. And then we found out that the company could not compete worldwide. And in the end, of course, they went bankrupt. And so 1,100 employees have lost their jobs. And in a larger sense, because this goes to the $1 trillion stimulus package that the administration's been pushing, a lot of the money's been going out the door for different schemes like Solyndra, where they can't compete worldwide. And secondly, it's questionable whether they can even compete within the United States, because the contract for a half $1 billion was given out in 2009, and here we are in 2011. Where's the money? Where is the half $1 billion? And where's the interest on half $1 billion?
Okay, but let me just back up, because so there's a lot in there. So you feel your suggestion is that the Treasury Department made this loan, which was basically guaranteed by the Energy Department to this company,
yeah,
over some problematic red flags. Because why? Why did they do
it? Well, Megan, what happened is OMB, the Office of Management Budget, is responsible, has a fiduciary responsible of looking at these contracts and making a recommendation. Now, as chairman of the Oversight Investigation Committee, I've done a 6 months investigation of this. I couldn't get the information. They are uncooperative. So after 6 months, I issued a subpoena. So that was the first indication something's awry here. Why won't they provide information about this? And lo and behold, OMB did not recommend that this go forward. So why did the administration push forward on this scheme, so to speak, when they did not have the full support of Office of Management Budget, who
What's
has the responsibility?
What's the answer to that? Why did they?
That's a good question. Why did the administration go? Was it political? There wasn't enough, shall we say, technical information to make that this company, Solyndra, could be competitive enough worldwide as well as even competently managed to actually do this because the people
were involved. Well, what would be the incentive? What would be the incentive on their part? I mean, you mentioned this guy who does bundling.
Well, Mr. Kaiser was the initial person who did bundling for the president, and I'm just saying he's one of the initial big investors. You know, another big question, Megan,
okay, but that suggests it's political payback. It doesn't sound like you got him on that. I mean, that's just your theory at this point, correct?
Well, I'm just saying a lot of this money that was given out, what we're finding out is that some of it is not at the recommendation of OMB, whose responsibility for overseeing this, but is on a recommendation of the administration, which in many cases, it looks to me, it might be political rather than technical incompetence.
Well, so now what happens? Now, basically, the company has gone belly up. 1,100 people
right.
are out. This is all part of the stimulus money, right? This is supposed to create jobs and people put people back to work. Now 1,100 people are out of work and the taxpayers are out $500 million. So what happens now? Do we get that money back somehow? Can we go into bankruptcy court and try to, you know, get some dough from this company?
Megan, here's another problem with the Solyndra. Is they were having trouble, so they went to the private venture capitalists, about five hedge funds, and they asked for about $75 million. Well, it turns out the government allowed with that tranche of money to let these people get first out instead of the American taxpayers. And that's a reason why I'm going to have a continued series of hearings on Solyndra to understand why we couldn't get the information. Secondly, why they went ahead with it. And what about this agreement where the hedge funds get their money back first instead of the American taxpayers?
I just want to let our viewers know that the Energy Department went on the record with the Washington Post saying, quote, "We've always recognized that not every one of the innovative companies supported by our loans and loan guarantees would succeed." And, you know, went on from there talking about there are risks inherent in these type of efforts. Last point I want to make before I let you go, sir, and that is that apparently the Government Accounting Office, which sort of keeps an eye on government, says that similar defaults could happen with other loan guarantee projects that were not properly vetted. How big a concern is that? Need a quick answer.
That's a real big concern because we spent $1 trillion here, and if Solyndra is any example, then we've got to be concerned about billions of dollars not performing, in the end, not providing job. Tragically, in this economy, to have this kind of thing happen is wrong.
Representative Cliff Stearns, thank you so much, and we welcome anyone from the administration, Energy, Treasury, OMB, or otherwise who wants to come on and discuss this so we can have both sides represented. Sir, all the best to you.
Thank you.